Hello friends, welcome to the tutorial of C programming. In this video we are going to study a triangle pattern. Okay, in last video I covered the grid pattern and today we will cover the triangle pattern. So as you can see, these are the various examples of triangle pattern. Okay, again one more example of nested for loop. So as you can see here, your first row is having 1 star, second row having 2 star, and third row is having 3 star. Okay, so let us write a code for this. So basically we want to write a code that will work for n number of lines. So definitely you are going to have a n lines, and as our for loop represents, outer for loop represents row, so it will definitely run from 1 to n. Okay, it will definitely run from 1 to n. Now we have to make a changes in our inner for loop condition. It will also start with 1, okay, but where it will terminate? So as you can see here, for my first row I want to print a single star, for my second row I want to print 2 star, and for my third row I want to print 3 star. So as you can determine here that the column's value is dependent on our row value. Okay, and row is represented by this I variable and column is represented by this j variable. So j will start with 1 and terminate at i. Okay, so let us check. See, the value of I is what? Currently 1. So j will start from 1 to 1. So my inner loop will execute how many times? 1 time. And in this loop what we are going to write? We are going to write printf star. Okay, now when the value of I will be 2, when the value of I will be 2, j will again start from 1 and will terminate at 2, means it will run how many times? It will run 2 times. Okay, so actually here I have to say star, right? Shouldn't be %d. Here I have to say star. Okay, when next time I's value will be 3, my j loop will run from 1 to 3, means how many times it will run? 3 times, and this 3 star get printed. And whenever we are completing with our inner loop, don't forget to print new line. Okay, so our output will appear on separate line. Okay, so let us dry run this part. See, I have I and j. Initially I is 1. We are going to do this process for 3 times. Here I am considering the value of n as 3. Okay, so is 1 less than 3? Yes, it is less than 3. Now j get initialized with 1 and it is compared against I. So is j less than or equal to I? Yes, it is equal. So it will come inside this loop and this star get printed. Next time the value of j will be incremented by 1, it will be 2. Okay, and again it will be compared with I. Is j less than I? No, now it is not less than, not even equal. So condition evaluates to false. It will come outside the inner loop and this new line get printed. So our cursor will transfer to the new line and I will be incremented by 1. So here your value evaluates to what? False. Then I get incremented and j will again start from what? 1. So is j less than I? Yes, it is less than I. So next star get printed and the value of j get incremented by 2. Sorry, by 1. So now it will be 2. So is it less than or equal to 2? Yes, it is equal. So again second star get printed and then j value get incremented by 1. Now 3 is not less than 2, so condition evaluates to false. Okay, and I get incremented by 1, so I will be what? 3. Okay, now j will again start from 1 and it will run how many times? It will run 3 times, and when it becomes 4, condition evaluates to false. And next time the value of I will be 4. Now 4 is not less than n. As you can see here, what condition we put? I less than or equal to n. So I value is 4 and n value is what? It is 3. So your condition evaluates to false and your loop terminates. Okay. Now to get this pattern, to get this number triangle, okay, what we have to do? Look at here. Value of j is 1 for first iteration, then value of j is 1, 2. Okay. Then value of j will be 1, 2, 3. Okay. So what we have to print? We have to print the value of j to get this pattern. See, look at here, your values are changing column wise. So for that, you have to print the value of j. If you want to print this pattern, okay, your values are changing row wise, so you have to print I. So for this iteration, I will be 2. For this 2 value, I will be 2. So 2 times 2 get printed. For this value, I will be 3. So 3 get printed. Okay. So let us run this program first, and then after we will write a program or for pattern ABC and this inverted triangle. So let us switch to code block. So for I equal to 1, then I less than or equal to n, then I plus plus. For j equal to 1, j less than or equal to I and j plus plus. Now there is just a single statement, so I am not going to enclose it in curly braces. So let me put a star here, and when I completed with the inner for loop, I will say printf slash n. Okay, so let us execute it. Yes, so let me enter 5 lines. Look at here, one first line has 1 star, second line has 2 star, and so on, and fifth line has 5 star. So let us print the value of I instead of star. So if you print the value of I instead of star, what happened? Your value will change row wise. Okay, let us have a look to a output. See, values are changing row wise. 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4, and 5 times 5. Instead of this I, if I print j, what happens? My value will change column wise. Means I should get output 1, 1, 2, like this. See, again 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so now let us write a code for pattern ABC. Okay, now as you can see here, my which value is changing? Column wise my value is changing. So definitely I have to do modification in my inner loop. Okay, so I have to initialize my j with 97, because 97 is the ASCII value of small a. Okay, now definitely I cannot say j is less than I, because what happened here? If I say j less than I, j is always going to be greater than I, because we are initializing I with 1 and we are initializing j with 97. So definitely j is always greater than I, and this loop condition never satisfies. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to say j is less than 97 plus I. Okay, so look at here, a is the 97 is the ASCII value of a, then 97, and then we are printing 98, then 97 again, 98 and 99. Okay, so initially value of I is what? 1. We are initializing j with 97. And we are comparing j with 97 plus I. Means here in this case it will be 98. 97 plus 1 is what? 98. So 97 is less than 98. Yes. So we have to print what? We have to print character. Okay. So to print the character, I have to say percent %c in the double quote, and then I'll say j. Don't forget to specify the percent %c format specifier, otherwise that numerical values get printed. Next time when the value of I will be 2, see, my loop will run from 97 to 99, less than 99, because 97 plus 2 is what? 99, and we are saying less than not equal to, so it will work for 97 and 98. Okay, so let us do this modification in our code and let us check the output. So as I told you here, I have to say 97, so less than 97 plus I, and here instead of percent D, what I have to say, percent C. So let us run this. Okay, let me build it again because we changed the code. Say 5, see A B A B A B C A B C D A B C D E. So you got this pattern also. Now if you want capital case letter, in that case you have to initialize your J with 65, that's it, and condition will be what, 65 plus I. So I hope you got this. Now next is inverted triangle. What we are going to do, we are going to print an inverted triangle. Now in inverted triangle, basically your first row will have 3 star, second row will have 2 star, and third row will have what, 1 star. Okay, means again we want to print what, again we want to print a 3 rows. Okay, so let me modify this code, let me erase this code first, we will write this again. So definitely I want to print 3 rows, but now this time what will I do? Instead of starting my I from 1, I start it from n, and I will decrement the value of I by 1 till it reduces to 1. Okay, so that's why what condition I put, decrement the value of I till it is greater than or equal to 1, because initially I is definitely going to be greater than 1. Okay, now here I'll say for j is equal to 1, j less than or equal to I, and j plus plus. Now printf star printf new line, and that's it. Okay, now let us check how our program will work. So here I am considering that value of n as 3. So I initialize my I with n, which is 3. Now my j loop is starting from 1 and it will terminate at I. So what is the current value of I? I is what? I is 3. Currently the value of I is what? 3. And what we are saying here? Start from 1 and go till it is less than or equal to I. So it will run how many times? It will run 3 times, and that's why we will get 3 star. Now next time the value of I will be decremented by 1. So the value of I will be what? 2. Again it will start from 1, inner loop start from 1 and goes till it is less than or equal to I. So means it will run from for 1 to 2, means it will run 2 times. Next time this value will be 1. So it will run for 1 to 1 times, means exactly 1 time. Then it becomes 0, the condition evaluates to false, because what condition we wrote here? Continue this loop till it is greater than or equal to 1, when it will be 0. 0 is not greater than or equal to 1. Okay, so I hope you got this. You have to just do a little modification in your program to get a specific pattern, and once you understand it, definitely you will also enjoy this program, and we will run this program in code block. So as I told you, what changes we have to do? I have to say I is equal to n. Here I is greater than or equal to 1, and now since we are starting with a bigger value, so I have to decrement the I. And for j, j will start normally with a 1, it will terminate at j less than or equal to I, and j plus plus. Now here we want to print a fixed pattern, which is star, so just specify the star in double quote. So let us check this. Say 5. See, you got an inverted triangle where first line has 5 star, then 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. So try to create your own pattern and try to solve it. So definitely you will enjoy this, and this will also help you to improve your logic. In next video, we will study a different type of pattern. Okay, again we are going to study the triangle pattern, but that is going to be little bit different than this. Thank you.